to speak a little bit about emerging markets in general. Emerging markets went through, so far, pretty nasty correction, just about 20%. It just might be that emerging markets is a better place for us to put money to work. We are contrarians in nature, we look for value. For example, Chinese internet players that we are going to start paying attention to. One of them is Tencent, down 10% so far, not enough. Still selling at, I think, 35 times earnings, not that cheap. But one should not ignore the fact that Tencent is a substantial reach in the Chinese market. For example, if you take the reach of, say, Facebook, you look at Twitter, Instagram, you get one Tencent as far as reach. You cannot ignore that. On their WeChat, they serve about 2 ads per individual. Facebook serves 20 per individual. So they have tremendous growth potential in the pipeline. You cannot ignore the fact that they also have a major footprint in the Chinese market with PayPal, cloud services, and gaming. The gaming market in China is huge, about 575 million. And as much as the government tries to censor that market and is slow to let Tencent release new games to market, which is the cause why Tencent is down nowadays, they cannot stop that gaming phenomenon in China. One better way to be in the Chinese market is via Google, which we own. And the reason I mention Google is because over the weekend I read an article about one segment of what they do, which is Waymo, that is autonomous driving. And some companies like Evercore, I think, believe that that business is worth about $100 billion. Other companies like Morgan Stanley think it's worth actually $175 billion in valuation. So it's anywhere between 10 to 20% of Google's market cap. Waymo has different applications. They have an application into what we call the last mile. They can do delivery of groceries using that service. They can do licensing of their technology. They drove on a simulated basis close to 3 billion miles already. And obviously, hauling services. They can definitely compete with companies like Uber or partner with companies like Uber and Lyft. If they can only reduce pricing by 25%, and if they can start making 70 cents a mile, this is a major business. In a few years from now, they can be, just with that business alone, at $10 billion annual sales. The gaming market is a huge market in size and in growth. Up to now, that market was made out of 300 to 400 million players in the US. But in the US, like in the rest of the world, it's based on the gaming consoles, the devices, the hardware devices that mostly the young generation buys to play. These devices are expensive. They cost $300-$400 a piece, or you might use a powerful computer that costs about $1,000 a piece. There is a change coming, and we need to be prepared for that. And the change is that the day that we're going to use cloud-based downloads, streaming of gaming is arriving. In fact, in the next few years, some say the next 2 years, it's already happening. So right now, about 75% of all games are played on consoles. Mm-hmm. And the thinking is that very soon, in the next 2 years or so, about 40% of these games are going to be downloaded on a Netflix-type platform, whereby you pay $10, $15 per month, and you can get all the games you can think of, including what they call AAA-type games, FIFA, and also the Call of Duty, Electronic Arts, for example. A company like that can actually grow their revenues 4 times faster in the next 2 years. And the gaming market can go from 300 to 400 million players into the billions. And it's not going to be just the space for the young kids, it's going to be the space for older individuals that would like to play, say, older games, Pac-Man and games of that sort. When you start opening the gaming market on a subscription basis and you do, and you can download it into an old iPhone that you had in your hand for 2 years on a TV, on any PC, and play the game as good as anyone else, then the market changes. Hello, everybody. My name is Amit Stavinsky, and I'm the Managing Director of Investments at Tamar Securities LLC and its affiliates, Firefighters United and 911 Financial Services. I want to thank you all for taking the time, first and foremost, to watch our videos. And if you have any questions, please feel free to call us in our main offices in Woodland Hills, California at 818-914-7460 or check our website at tamarsecurities.com. The highlight of the week is that bull markets, as long as they are currently 10 years long, do not die of old age.